Yeah.
Have you seen a shrink?
I think,
just kidding.
Yeah, I think I should. I like Anupam wants me. It's almost schizophrenic to meet you. I mean, I can't discuss your content in the same breath. But I think that's all of us. We all have different personalities. I just get a chance to express through my different personalities by making different kinds of content.
Well taken. Yes, that side, please. Yeah.
Hi, Ekta Ravi from.
Hi, Ravi.
Ravi from ABP News. एकता जैसे कि अभी बताया आपने कि सब जानते भी हैं कि टीवी इंडस्ट्री में टीवी एक्टर्स किस तरह से सीरियल्स बनते हैं और किस तरह से आपकी रेस्पेक्ट है और किस तरह से काम निकालना आपको आता है सारे एक्टर्स से. लेकिन जब आपने फिल्म में फॉरे किया तो जो फिल्म इंडस्ट्री है और फिल्म जो सुपर स्टार्स हैं और स्टार्स हैं उनके विम्स एंड फैंसी पे चलती है. ऐसे बहुत सारी स्टोरीज हैं कि वो स्क्रिप्ट में भी चेंज करवाते हैं, वो ये भी तय करते हैं कि कौन होना चाहिए कौन नहीं होना चाहिए, हीरो हीरोइन से लेके बाकी एक्टर्स तक. तो जब उनके ईगोज आते हैं बीच में तो वो कैसे आपने मैनेज किया और क्या इस तरह के कुछ आपको बुरे अनुभव हुए बॉलीवुड में जब आप उनसे बड़े स्टार से डील कर रही थी?
मेरे लिए बहुत टफ हुआ पहले ये समझना कि अब आई एम नॉट द डिसाइडिंग फैक्टर, डायरेक्टर होगा. सी, लाइन प्रोड्यूसर्स एंड क्रिएटिव प्रोड्यूसर्स एंड टेलीविजन हैव द से. Suddenly it was the director, which is who's the captain of the ship in films. That itself was a big switch. Then it came into the fact that actors, they have to bite into a script and then only you can make it. So I started doing smaller films. I luckily got the chance to work with Ajay Devgan and Imran Hashmi with Once Upon a Time in Mumbai. And Ajay sir gave me a chance and he heard my story and Milan sir and Ajay sir knew each other, so it happened. But yeah, it was tough, but luckily for these few films, I got a great, I landed up making films with actors who wanted to work with me and gave me that respect. The bigger stars, I think I stayed away only because I knew that I didn't know if I would manage making those films.
Ekta, koi example, aap bina naam liye share karna chahenge, kuch bure experience stars se aapko huye?
Nahi, main... मेरे कोई बुरे एक्सपीरियंस एज सच नहीं हुए हैं एज सच, बिकॉज आई डोंट थिंक बुरे एक्सपीरियंसेस ऐसे, मतलब कि हाँ ऑफकोर्स मैंने लाइक आप नॉर्मली जब किसी बड़े स्टार को लेते हो तो आपके जो उनके जो एंटोराजेस होते हैं मैनेजर्स होते हैं वो बड़े बुरे एक्सपीरियंस होते हैं. बिकॉज एक ही होटल में कुछ 12 रूम बुक होते हैं, उसके बाद आप टीवी से आए हो जहाँ आप एक रूम में 12 लोगों को लगाते हो सडनली उसमें आप भी होते हो सडनली इतना एक्सपेंस इतना ऑप्युलेंस, मतलब नॉर्मली इट्स फॉर अस इट वाज अ बिग माइंड शिफ्ट यू नो, सो दैट वाज अ बिट शॉकिंग.
थैंक यू.
आई हैड कम स्ट्रेट ऑन दिस टेबल.
हाय एकता, हेमंत हो गया, हेमंत सर. अच्छा एकता, यू आर वेरी पर्टिकुलर अबाउट कास्टिंग इन योर टीवी सीरीज. या एंड यू गो बाय सम एस्ट्रोलॉजिकल और व्हाटएवर यू नो दिस यानी, इज इट अ फैक्ट समथिंग?
सो यू नो आई हियर एवरी डे अ न्यू थिंग. नाउडेज आई हैव स्टार्टेड गेटिंग कुंडलीज आल्सो ऑन माय मोबाइल. व्हाट आई डू व्हिच आई रियली वांट टू डू से इज that I check legally if actors are free or not. That's a big one for us now. Mm-hmm. Balaji has a legal cell because in daily soaps, I have cast two kids in my web show. After shooting the web show, they told us that they have signed up the daily show. So I was stuck because it was my own show. With this kind of big level of content, we do a big search on how legally they are clean or not, because with web and TV and movies, everyone is taking small roles here and there, and then you're stuck. That one. Secondly, I cast people on instinct. Mm. When I'm seeing an audition, I'm usually tying my shoelaces by eating something, walking, and I'm doing casting. I don't even like somebody telling me that this one is that one's friend. I'm that honest to my job. And I know nobody believes that because I get so many questions on, this is a big part of the folklore. But yes, my titles are astrologically approved. My dates are astrologically approved.
Dates of what?
Dates on when to launch.
Okay, okay.
And I wear a lot of rings and they are astrologically approved. I think I'm also astrologically approved.
because you are quite bang on when you are casting. Most of your casting is successful.
So you think it's an astrologer? Oh, it's my brains. Little credit to me.
Yeah. Because your belief in astrology makes you do the right casting for that matter. And then because you have got a...
My belief in astrology is this much, that I definitely... But you know, a lot of people told me, you believe so much in astrology, why do you work so hard? Right. I was like, if astrologically everything worked out, then I should be sitting at home and partying and not doing any work.
Yeah, but having worked hard, you have become instinctively more accurate as such.
Yeah, so that also.
And that works as simple as that.
Yes.
Hi, ma'am. This is Poonam here.
Hi, Poonam.
Yeah, I really respect you a lot.
Thank you so much.
I follow a lot to you. Every place on your Insta, Facebook, Twitter, and wherever you go, I follow. I
stalker.
ma'am, I just wanted to know, like, whenever you have these problems and failures come, so how you tackle those things? Like, how you manage?
My dad told me something very interesting. He told me, "This too shall pass. If you're very successful, it'll pass. If you're having a horrible day, it'll pass." Life will pass, everything changes. Badlav hi duniya ka shashwat niyam hai. So, chahe wo bad time ho ya good time ho, you cannot get stuck to the outcome. It's not in your hands. You can definitely enjoy the process. So, I don't know if Alt Balaji will be the biggest app or not. I don't care. I love the process. And as long as you stuck to the process, na, the outcome, you will look at it as reverence ke saath. With nonchalance. It doesn't matter.
That's good. Ma'am, one more question. I want to ask you that...
What is your phone number?
I sure have not get ma'am's number. But I want to ask you, I know people talk a lot about you, that you're scaring people. People are scared from you. You are very hard rocking. You, whatever you decide, you do that. That is a passion you have in yourself. But I don't understand that after doing so many good things, actually, when you bless people, it happens good only for people. Then why people talk like this? I mean, maine suna hai ki aap jis pe bhi haath rakhte ho, uski life change ho jati hai, and that person goes aage, whatever. So you're doing all good only. You're doing all best. So why this all talks are there?
My friend, life mein na, always remember, I used to be a human being, now I'm folklore. I'm sure some of it is true. I'm human. I've made some mistakes in life. And I always believe when one person is cast, four people are abusing me because they didn't get cast. So that's life.
Hello. Hi, Ekta.
Hi,
Chaitanya here. Yeah, Ekta, you know, just out of curiosity, you have a legendary actor, you know, your dad, Jitendra. Is there a conscious decision that you do not kind of want to have a professional, you know, kind of arrangement where he works in one of your productions?
No, I asked him once a long time ago, I said, would you want to act? And I know he likes acting. But he said something to me that he said, no, I don't want to. And I said, why? He said, no, I'm enjoying the running my business and doing my own thing. So I never pushed it. And I've constantly thought that I should offer him something and make him work. But I realized that he liked seeing himself on the big screen. And I don't know if he wants to do a daily soap. Secondly, he's not that young now. And I didn't push it, but I asked him a couple of times and he said, no, he doesn't want to act.
Has he withdrawn himself from public life in general, your dad?
No, he does go out with his friends, but he does a lot more socially. He's always like he's attending events and somebody will call him up, some old acquaintance of his whose son's function he has to go to. So he's 24/7 doing this,
right.
Attending, and it doesn't matter. For him, it's very, if he's had an old acquaintance, he's, you know, I think people of that time were like that, you know. It didn't matter that you're not working anymore with each other. We'll still go. So he actually has a far busier social life than mine also. And but he is definitely now, there's a resistance to act again. And I don't know why.
Because we've been trying to give him
the Lifetime Achievement Award at the Jagran Film Festival for 3 years now. If you can please put in a word, that'll be lovely.
Of course, I'd love to see him get that.
I just did that in public. Thank you. Next one. Next question, please. Yes.
Probably it has no answer, but at what team size can one have an ever-growing empire? Like, you know, if you have a staff of 4, you can only manage 1 or 2 businesses, right? But maybe at 20 or 30 core team, you can probably have everything that you want to do.
I can't really answer this question because team size, as big as the work you're doing is, so when I was doing, I had to downsize when I was doing no show. I tried to retain all my staff at that time, but I did downsize as far as people who are freelancers, but the amount of work you do decides the size of the talent you can hire, and of course it's a big blessing if you can hire more people. It gives buoyancy to the company.
Okay, Ekta, I have 2 questions for you. First of all, one of my friends who works in the OTT industry told me something very interesting. Domestic market mein, Secret Games has apparently, one of your shows, Kehne Ko Humsafar, has performed 10 times better than Sacred Games. Is it correct? Is this information correct?
I can't comment on anyone else's show.
But there's no way to know because
there's no way to know, and I won't know their numbers. And I believe that, you know, there's the same audience who watches Sacred Games who watch Kehne Ko Humsafar. I really don't want to go into who's done how many numbers, you know. And we are all doing our jobs, yeah. So really, like, but I'm so happy that people watched my show and they liked it. So I did a show which was about the other woman, which was always called the vamp on television. So I was like, happy doing it.
Yeah. Also, there's this petition in the Delhi High Court, which is about setting up a regulatory body that will censor what's going on OTT platforms. Your comment.
You
on that.
Have just scared the shit out of me.
Yeah. We'll let that pass.
Yeah, please. There has to be some expression. There has to be a place we can talk things that society will only change when things are spoken. Good, bad, ugly.
One last question. It's also late in the night. Yes, right there. Mike, please.
Ma'am, you have been doing soap opera in television for so many years, decades, more than a decade, and you have created so many properties. And it runs long-running properties. So they've used a lot of tropes in the shows. So in such a position, how do you come up with new ideas for your television medium if you want to continue working in that soap opera space? Where does new ideas emerge
from? So you have to innovate, not only getting new ideas, it's also, I told you, very tough because you cannot get radical on television. And you're going into people's houses. So more than just getting new ideas, you have to get sometimes the socio-economic, thinking, the how social change has happened in the last couple of years into your writing. I mean, I've recently, whenever I've written a soap, I've definitely had working women. What are issues they are facing? Even if you slightly touch it, it becomes far more relatable because every time the world changes, even the most conventional stories get a whole new edge because of the way the world is changing around you.
Final question from me, and I told you I'll ask you this question. And I can only ask you this question because you're an extremely self-aware person. You can see your work very objectively from a distance. What is the most ridiculous thing you've done on TV and gotten away with it?
You want me to name one? That's damn tough, yeah?
Okay, make that two.
Okay, so many years ago, I did this show and it was my first, I think it was a supernatural come sci-fi show, and I had to have episodic, so I had this episodic on Ichhadari Nagin. Of course, we later on did a lot of that, as we all know, but at that time it was one episode, and everyone knows that budgets in Doordarshan were very small at that time. And my director suddenly on the set says, I can't shoot with a snake. I'm like, oh, I have a phobia. I'm like, oh my God, we can't cancel the shoot. She's like, I can't shoot with a snake. I'm like, but you know, when the human being converts into a snake or shapeshifts, there has to be a snake. She's like, I can't shoot with a snake. And we were not so adept in special effects at that time. So we changed the story to Ichhadari Machli. I was like, I hope none of my friends see this. I'd never hear the end of it. And it was an episode on Ichhadari Machli, which was quasi, you know, the mermaid. And it rocked television, Doordarshan. So the highest rating on the Ichhadari Machli. I got away with it. I never did it again. I'm telling you, for the first time I did that. I think once when we had Smriti and Amar in Kyunki, we had them shoot Paris in Balaji. Of course, we had very stringent budgets. So we had put one Eiffel Tower outside the window, had a fireplace in summers in Bombay, given them coats. And in that arc lights, they were shooting an episode where they were saying, "Arre, itni thandi hai. Oh God, this Paris mein kitni thandi hai." I think I got away with Paris shot in Balaji was, I think, the most ridiculous thing I could do.
So what happened in the scene? So this person is looking at Paris and got
Paris. I mean, so in our office, we do anything. Outside the window, they had those, you know, the snow machines. Hmm. So it's like, arre, bahar itni thandi ho rahi hai. You can see the snow machine. They have a, but it worked, but we didn't have the budget. Like I told you, when for the first time I did a film and I realized that everyone has different rooms. Here we were like, lunch break mein everyone used to run down. There was one makeup van for 5 actors. The budget was 1,30,000. I remember when Star Plus called me up and we thought we got a huge budget with 90,000 to make an episode. And I got Tarun Katyal's call. Sameer Nair asked him to call me. Called my mom. And my mom said, "No, Tarun, we can't make it in less than 90,000. But if you say, we'll make it in 75 because we wanted the job." Mm. And he said, "No, I'm increasing the budget to 135, but just shoot with one more camera." And we were like, 1,35,000 for an episode? I thought that suddenly, what is it? What are we going to do with the extra money?
But tell me something, and this is actually the final question. The swish pan, where twing, 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 did you come up with it? Where was the first time you used it? It's become like a thing that we know television.
Darang, 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 and swish pans. So I, like you just heard, that we didn't have the budgets for great swipes and everything. And we wanted the audience to know there's an important moment coming. So you underline with music, darang, darang, darang. And if the woman is cooking in the kitchen, she realizes, oh God, something big happened. She comes out. And then you have those great swish pans on somebody's face. Suddenly, say, oh shit, huge drama. Let's sit down and watch, you know. Now, of course, we have those pullbacks and we have trolleys and we have drones. But at that time, we had one camera. We shot 22 minutes in a day.
Hmm.
And we had to do what we would call like great amount of twists and turns. And this was one formula that really worked for us. So we just continued with it. I'm telling you, necessity is the mother of all invention. If darang, darang, darang is getting the woman out of the kitchen to see the next scene, darang, darang, darang it was.
And darang, darang, darang is going to be. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Ekta Kapoor.
No, Srivastava to present Ekta Kapoor with a memento. Thank you once again to Ekta Kapoor for giving us such an interesting finale at the Jagran Cinema Summit. We've had a wonderful time listening into her conversation with Mayank Shekhar there. Thank you. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, Ekta Kapoor, and this was the finale session at the Jagran Cinema Summit. I thank all our speakers, our moderator, and our audience for the day. Ladies and gentlemen, we at the Jagran Cinema Summit hope that in the years ahead, we will continue to receive your patronage and presence at the future summits. Here's to the love of cinema. Have a great evening ahead. Namaskar.